Hi everyone, this is Hina Beg and I'm a solution therapist. So we are back with the stress part, how to manage it. As we have already gone through the S, the T, the R, I'll just quickly recap it. The S was for sit, sift and sip. The T, try to breathe, triggers to be noted and the tough decisions to be made. R was to realize your potential, read the clues and rest your mind. I hope you have done that, and I believe that you will be practicing it also further on, because now it was 9 things that you had to remember and practice with or without the situation. Remember, you are preparing yourself and more work is needed when the preparation is being done. Coming to E, first thing is exercise. You have to inculcate a habit of exercising. It could be for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, that is separate, but do some action, do some physical activity. Then engage yourself with positive thought process, engage with people you rely on, engage with somebody with a positive conversation. Do not understand the other person is thinking, suggesting, saying, and interpret your own self. Engage in a conversation rather than just sending message, waiting, and then it happens that people start reading the reply in their own tone because they have waited for a long time and then the reply came. So the time has lapsed wherein you have started building up emotionally. So you start reading the text in your own way. So engage in a conversation. Pick up the phone, dial and talk. Meet the person, have a conversation face to face. Then is expectation should be reduced. When I was talking about realizing your own potential, it also meant that when you are taking a decision whether to react or not to react, it is about your own expectations. How much are you expecting from the other person, from a situation? Then it will, you know, be there that you may get agitated if it does not meet your expectation. So that may give you stress. Like for example, if you had submitted any assignment or if you have completed a task given by your boss, and or if there is some work at home and you have done that work. So at times it is possible that you do it beyond your potential. You put that extra effort to complete it. It may not be needed, but you did it at that point of time. You took a decision, you did it. Fine. When the result came from the other side, when you received the R, the response from the other side, and it did not meet what you had thought about, you know, that person is going to say this and it will be accepted and they'll praise me and I'll be appreciated. All those things that you have thought, just because you had put in the extra effort, is then the expectation from your end. The E extra, the E effort, extra effort will then be backed by expectation. So when that is happening, always be very, very clear that it may lead to stress. So keep that in mind. Reduce your expectation. You give your best. You wanted to put the extra effort? Fine, go ahead and do it. You should be really satisfied with the work that you have done. So keep that in mind. Now you have S, T, R and E. That's sit, sift, sip, try to breathe, triggers, tough decision, realize your potential, read the clues, rest your mind, and now exercise. Engage and expect less. I hope you'll remember and you have to try to see how you are going to practice that. Take up any situation, try to practice it. Go through that thought that had made you stressed out. Try to rewire yourself. See you tomorrow with the next letter, that is S. Till then, take care and practice with or without any stressful situation. Take care. Bye.